Hi guys, how are you guys doing? If you guys ask me, I am feeling so much better compared to the last 2 weeks that I've been sick. It's not super sick, just flu and colds, but it's annoying enough to make you not want to do anything and just stay in bed. Today I will be sharing a tutorial for this lovely lotus flower requested by Lee Sang. Thank you so much, SL Kitty, for requesting this one because it turned out to be absolutely amazing and I really, really like it. When she first requested it, I looked at it and it's like, oh, it looks so complicated, so I kind of just waited a little bit to make it, and today I was able to make it, and it's actually really pretty. I will be making some changes today. This flower has four petals, as you can see, so I'll just add one more to make it five because I think it looks better that way. And then that would come up the out, since this is four, we have eight petals outside, so if we add one more petal here, then that's going to end up having 10 petals on the outside part. So let's go ahead and start. Excuse me. Today we are going to be using the blue, or I'm going to be making a blue lotus flower, because I don't really make two of the same color. And the blue one is really pretty. Me and my husband are actually talking about it last night. So we are debating between purple and blue, but I end up with blue. I really love blue. So I used the clear rubber bands, Rainbow Loom brand. I don't ever use a different brand because I just don't trust them. First time I used them, I made this really, really pretty hair bow, and then after like a few months, like maybe 2 months or something, it's just start to get brittle and start breaking all over the place. So I got the clear bands. This will be, so you can see, for those needle kind of looking the beaded one. This one's right here, and yellow for the middle part. So for the yellow part, we need 15. So first 5 in the first middle, and then the second 10. So we need 15 for those ones. And then the clear ones, we need 20. I use two different tones of beads. I'm really not sure what size they are, but they are really, really tiny. There's Swarovski or something. So I don't know. My daughter has them, and I just took them from her. So there you go. I used two tones of beads for that. Again, you will need 20 of those. And then I will use the electric blue, glow-in-the-dark electric blue, for the light color right there, and then the ocean blue for the dark color, the dark part. I just want it to be two-toned today, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to do that. Okay, so enough talking, let's go ahead and start. So like I said, you need 15 of your yellow, and then your clear is 20. I will use a clear band for the cap band. So for the first band, so it's up to you if you use like 3, but I would like to make it tighter. So I'm gonna double fold it. So instead of 3, I have like 4 in there. And then we're going to take our first one. We're going to do our first 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same thing with the box flower pattern from Iris Handmade's. The middle part will be like that. So if you have any question about the beading, you can go ahead and check her Foxflower Chrysanthemum tutorial, because she have a part in there that she shows how to attach the beads onto your rubber bands. So that's our first one. So go lock it in, and then we're going to go back to our cap band. So this is kind of tight. You just have to plan it and be careful not to lose your cap band. And it's ideal to use a different color so you don't get confused. That's two. Third one. So you can use any kind of yellow for the middle part, but the ones I'm using right now are the neon yellow. Go back to your cap band. Grab another band, slide it in, and then lock it in. So that's our fourth one. Now we're gonna go get our last one. So this is a very easy pattern if you have done crochet, some of my crochet flowers before, you will be able to easily follow it. So that's our first layer, that's the middle part, and now we're going to go to the second one. So you're going to find your first teardrop shape right here. Where is it? Okay, right there. You're going to find your first teardrop chain next to your hook, and then now we're going to start adding two of this beaded band in each chain. So that's one, and then go back to the same chain, two, because we have five chains. Then we're going to end up with 10 beaded bands. So second one, and then we're going to go to the next chain. The second one, go back to the next chain and your second beaded band. Okay, and now we're down to our last chain. First band. Final chain. So all our 10 beaded bands, and the second layer is done. So now, so we have that. Then our next chain. So we have, so now this time we have 10 chains, because we have 5 a while ago, and we attached 2 bands two bead events in each one, so now we have 10 chains. So in each chain, I love this song. Used to. Okay, go to the first chain, or first chain next to your last band right here. And then here, we are going to attach two of this clear beads. Or clear beaded band. Or clear bands. Anyhow, attach your second color, the clear one. So it's ideal to use a clear band for this one, just to show like the fade and the glow effect, just like this. Okay, so we attach two of those in each chain, and we have 20 of those. That's one. Go to the next chain. Grab two. Attach your two. That's your second one. Go to the next chain. So just finish those 10 chains, attach those 20 beads, two bands in each one, so that's two beaded bands, and I'm reminded of you. Okay, that's like my second to the last chain, and I'm down to my last chain right here. Attaching my last two clear beaded band. Okay, so that's how it looks like so far. These will stand up later. When we add our next chain. So, for this one, now we're gonna go ahead and go to the next chain. Next to this. So we're gonna grab our next chain. And then we are gonna go ahead and start with our crochet. Just regular crochet. Or crochet my way. We're going to start with our blue. So for this one, we are going to do, in each chain, we are going to do single crochet, double crochet, triple crochet, and then double single. So there's 5 chains in each one. And we are going to be using 2 bands each. So I'm just going to go ahead and hook all those in. So that's 1. And your first one in, for my crochet is always 2 for the first one. So that's 1. And next one is double crochet. Oops, sorry. Sorry. Just a little bit change because I gotta mix. So your first one, your first color blue, and then your second tone will be on top. So, and then that's the first single crochet. Second double crochet. One, two. And then grab this, hook them all in. So when you hook them all in, that is your darker color. Go back to the same chain and do your triple. Candles burning. One, two, three, and then two bands, hook them all in, and then on your third chain, which is your triple crochet, we're going to go chain two more in here. There's one, two, and then we're going to go back to that band, grab two, then hook them all in. So that way we have their little teardrop shape. So that's our triple crochet. Now we're going to go back to double. So one. Head on my shoulder. Feeling so maybe you'll start to cry. That's your double crochet. Grab two, your darker color bands, hook them all in, and then go back to the same chain, do your single crochet. Grab your darker shade, and then hook them all in. So that's our first petal. So pretty. I love it. And then you're gonna go to the next chain. Grab your darker, your second color band, and then hook it in. So that's just one, it's not a slip knot, but it's kind of like that. So we skip a chain, now we have 10 chains here, and we're going to have 5 petals. So one chain has one petal, and then skip, just chain 2 bands, then go to the next one and do the same thing again. So I'm going to go to the next chain. Maybe the old songs. So go to your next chain and work on your next petal. Hook that all in. So that's your first single crochet. Your darker color, hook them all in. Second double crochet. Grab your two bands, hook them all in, go back to your chain, your third one, which is your triple crochet, one, two, three, grab your next collar, hook them all in, and then that's our third. The triple crochet, we will do the added 2 chains again. So 1, 2, and then go back to that one, grab 2, hook them all in, go back to your caban or the chain, down to your double crochet. Please don't ask me what am I thinking, it's about you. Please don't ask me. Okay, I'm gonna fix that later. So one. My first impulse is to run to your side. And one? Single crochet. So it is going to be tight in that one chain, but it worked. So don't worry. The bands are super stretchy and it fits just fine. So that's our second one. Now we're gonna do the same thing to your next chain. It's just a skip. So just grab your darker shade, hook those all in, and then you're gonna go jump to the next chain. Then do it again. I'm gonna do it one more time, and then I'm gonna let you guys finish yours and finish mine off cam. So that way this one won't be too much. Too long. This one, double crochet right down to the end. Two, and third one, triple crochet. You gotta be careful that you don't grab those, because they get tangled. So one, two, the lion one time. So that's your triple crochet. Now we're gonna chain two of our darker color band. One, two, go back to that first darker, and then hook them all in, go back to your chain, do your double crochet, one, two, three, I'm sorry, hook them all in, then go back to your chain and do your last single crochet for this chain. One, two, hook them all in. So there you go. So same thing, next one is a skip, and then two more. So I'm gonna go let you guys finish it up. So in your next chain you will skip, and then another petal, next chain you will skip, and then another petal. So you are missing two more petals for this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this one off cam, and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So now that you're done with your first heart, it actually looks like a flower now. So like if you wanna make some flower in the future, you know, just whatever kind of flower, you're not trying to make anything in particular, then you can actually use this one and stop here. But we are not done to get a lotus flower effect. So now I am on my down to the last chain a while ago, so we're gonna go ahead and lock that in. That's our last band for our first layer, so it's easier if you just hold it like that for now. And then we're gonna go down to like those chains that we see inside. We should have like 10 of those. So now I'm gonna go ahead and grab the first one. So that's the first chain. So now I'm gonna go ahead and crochet away from me today. We're gonna do two single crochet on each chain. So we have 10 and we're gonna end up with 20. So I'm gonna go hook those hook that band in. So that's our first single crochet. grab a band, hook them all in. Second single crochet, go back to your next chain, go back to the same chain. So that's our second single crochet, hook them all in. Then now you're gonna go jump to the next chain, chain two, single crochet again, one, hook them all in, go back, two, hook them all in. So that's our second one, and then we're gonna go jump to the next chain. To now, able to show me how. One, go to the next chain. Me today. One. Same chain. Two. So now since we have 20, we're gonna end up with, we have 10, we're gonna end up with 20 chains by adding this single crochet to the single crochet in each chain. So we have 10 chains times two. We're gonna end up with 20. Same chain. Overflow. Life. Next chain. Second single crochet in that chain, go to the next chain, go back to the same chain, use second single crochet in that chain, and then to the next chain. One, two, I'm sorry, hook them all in, and then go back, do your second one. You take my breath away, hook them all in, do the next chain. It's the last one. We'll see. So we gotta count and make sure that we have 20 chain here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So we have one more chain somewhere there. Right there. So two more single crochet, one, take my breath away, and I don't know what to say, two, sorry about my singing, hook them all in. So that's our last one, and then you're gonna find this, the very first one right here. Not the bottom, the very first one on top. So I'm gonna go grab that. Grab two bands, hook them all in, and then lock it in. So now this one is gonna end up expanding like this, because we're gonna add up. So we have 20, right? I'm gonna add up 10 chains on those 20 chains, because it's 10 petal. because it's one petal, skip, another petal, skip. So if it's a 20 chain, we're going to have like 10 petals and 10 skips. So let me go ahead and show you how to do that. But first, I'm going to go ahead and restart the video. So I'm just going to go come back, and I will be right back in a few. Okay, I'm back. excuse me. So you can just go ahead and fix this stuff later. You know, when everything is all done and stuff, then you can just pull them in place and kind of fix them however you want it to be. So far our flower looks like this, and now we have this part. So now from that chain, you're gonna go back to that same chain, the very first chain right there, and then we're gonna go do the same thing with the petals. So I hooked that all in there. So that's our first single crochet. Go back, do your double crochet, one, two, dark band, hook them in, triple, one, two, three, dark band, hook them all in, and then the one, two. So I'm not sure how many bands you're gonna end up using for this one, because you know me, I don't count my bands. I'm so sorry about that. So kind of just estimate. Double crochet. One, two. Okay. And then the single crochet. So this is the same exact thing as the first part of the petals, the five petals we made, except we're making 10 instead of 5. So I need to be right back. My son is screaming. I'll be right back. Oh, okay. Sorry about that. That's my son. Man, my daughter is 10 years old. My son is 3, but he does not want to listen to my daughter at all. Anyway, so now we're gonna go to the next chain and then do the single chain, and then we're gonna go to the next chain and make another petal again, and we're gonna do this 10 times because we are gonna end up with 10 petals. So it is the same exact thing, so I'm going to go ahead and let you guys finish it up. So let me go ahead and finish this one more petal right here before I stop and do it off cam. One, two, start double crochet, dark band, hook them all in, go back to your chain, one, two, triple crochet, dark band, hook them all in. So this is the chain two, one, two, go back to the first one, hook them all in, and then double crochet. One, two, Hook them all in. Go back to your chain. One. Hook them all in. Then go to the next chain. Oops. For a bug. Grab your dark man. And hook those in. And then go to your next chain and start with another petal. So there you go, guys. We have two petals right now, and you still have eight to go. I'm going to go ahead and do it off cam. So that way I'll be faster. It's the same exact procedure. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And you finish yours as well. If you need to go back, if I'm too fast or something and you need to go back, all you have to do is just to hit rewind. There's no rewind, but just go back. Pause and go back or something. So, there you go. It's like I got OCDs and stuff, so I need to fix this. So it's not standing straight. There you go. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. Now we'll be right back for the final touches. We are almost done. I'll be right back. Whew. Okay. Hi guys, I'm back. So that's a lot of petals. So I'm now down here to the last chain I made right on this side. So now I'm going to go ahead and grab the very first one in the bottom right here. And then grab two bands, hook it in, and then lock it in. So we're going to go ahead and lock that in. And then we're going to go ahead and grab one of those bands and loop it over that chain again so we can tie it. Because we're going to go ahead and cut that off. Or it's up to you, you can hide it. So they don't keep on sticking out. You can just cut them off. So look. Excuse me. So now we're going to go ahead and try to fix or position our bands. I'm sorry, petals. The way we want them to be. So just kind of pull them a little bit. To get that shape. And then this. Position your beads. Straighten them up however you want them to be until you're happy with how it looks. So there you go. Excuse me. So, and then those bands, you can go ahead and just cut those off or just hide them somewhere. So there you go. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope you guys love this lotus flower. I actually love the way it looks. It's awesome. And so also when you make one, you consider if you want this one that has more petals, or like this one has that's just the difference. This one has four and this one has five. So, yep, this one has four and this one has five. To me, I really love this one, but I think I like the five petals better. So it's up to you. I think this one looks good. And They do come in different colors. They have purple, pink, white, yellow, blue. Common flower colors, I guess. So that's the most common colors they have. And so just remember to get that ombre look, or like the faded shading of the colors. All you have to do is just to use the lighter and then darker. Make sure you are using a lighter combination to a darker color of the same tone, so you don't go bad. It's like you don't make any mistakes with the color choosing, or the choice of color you end up making. That way it doesn't look, like it looks a lot realistic that way, instead of just combining whatever color or whatever shade. So there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And if you do end up making your own lotus flower, I would love to see your renditions. So please do tag me on my Instagram. My Instagram account is under MichelleKitter16. And I do have a Facebook page where you can always talk to me, leave a message, inquire, ask questions, or anything. It's under Personalized Loom Bands by Michelle Kitter, and that's my Facebook page. And if you are watching this tutorial, you are already on my YouTube page, so just go ahead and hit subscribe. And if you like this video, give this video a big thumbs up if you like it. And it would really help me if you guys do share. So share, like, share, and subscribe all the time, so that way I get more viewers. And that way I can come up with more tutorials. So there you go. There you go. Hope you guys have a great day, and can't wait to see your own lotus flower renditions. Thank you so much for watching. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.